He said, interpret it. It's interpreted as a tree, finally.
But mind is able to sense a form as well as smell as well as touch.
No. In this class, this much only. What is mind, we'll find out. So we'll have to understand what is mind. Okay, mind is smell, mind is taste, mind is touch. So mind is not different from any of them. Okay, one. Then another thing is, the mind can have only one sensation at a time. So when I am seeing, it can, the sound is not there. When I am hearing sound, the sense is not there. That's the nature of the mind. We'll have to understand it very more carefully.
Single thought at a time.
It's a single modification at a time. Okay, so when mind says, I am integrating, it is integrating some falsehood. There's nothing real integrated. Because it has seen and forgotten. And it is heard, it's forgotten. Then coming up with the concept saying that this is a tree. So, we have to understand the real nature of the mind. Okay, we have to go in more detail. Right now, I would say the mind is creating an illusion of something being there. Okay. Is this much clear to all? Okay. So, sense organs will never agree on anything. And mind takes the form of a sense organ, one sense organ at a time. So when it's hearing, then it switches out eyes, and then says, I heard and I saw. Then I'll say, this is it. But actually that mind is already shifted. Mind can only take one form at a time. It's like more like a movie. One frame, another frame, one frame, another frame. It appears like a continuous movie, it's not there. So what is there out here is I. Now do you agree? Do you agree or disagree?
What is out here is I.
Is it agree or disagree?
Your mind in tantu yenu alve lambe yenu adrusu
kitta. So that is false. I is everywhere is also false. Okay? I is nowhere is reality. Let me give you an example. Okay? So, visualize that you are there in the TV for some time. Not as a picture, or rather, visualize that you are in the fan. Can you visualize? I am in the fan. I am the fan. You can visualize? I am in the fan.
Yeah.
Can you visualize? Is it?
It's only visual.
Is it real?
No.
I cannot think of being anything other than here. Because everything else is an object. I am the subject. Subject cannot be in the object. Correct? What is an object? What is available to? Experience. So is this a subject or object? The body?
Object.
Then how can you think I am the body? How can you think I am in the body when the body is also an object? The real I is nowhere. Okay?
So witness.
There is nowhere.
No, now and here, both are not there.
But Guruji, we were saying that it is the witness. I am seeing through, the eye is not.
The witness is not anywhere. But it can see through everything.
It's now here.
It's now here.
It is not there anywhere, it is there everywhere.
The meaning of now here, okay, really is where there is no now and where there is no here. That is I. Okay, many people teach us where are they now here. That now here refers to I am. Now here is referring to I am.
Presence.
I am.
I am presence.
I am presence. But I is nowhere.
Now means the time, here means the space.
Space. Both
is beyond that.
Beyond that. That's I. Okay? I am is now here.
Then what is taking this form and
that is called, what takes the form is called mind. In your dream, the elephant came. What took the form of the elephant?
It's the thought, the mind.
Mind. Now also the mind has taken the form of you.
Body.
Wasn't it that the form happened and then the mind?
Mind is the form. You cannot separate out. For explanation purpose we can say. But otherwise, you cannot separate out these things sequentially. Okay? So then other thing is, what is mind? It is nothing but imagination of I.
So I exists from
Guruji. I exists where?
Everywhere.
Everywhere comes only after the imagination comes into picture. Before imagination, where was the I? See, when I say nowhere, not in time and not in space. The time and space is imagination in I. Okay? Understand? So, is I in imagination or imagination is in I?
I is
also
imagination.
Becomes the unmanifest.
Huh? This I becomes the unmanifest. No, unmanifest is another word. Unmanifest is actually equivalent of your deep sleep state.
Mm.
So, Sakshi, witness is beyond deep sleep state.
Mm.
So, what happens is that nowhere means not in time, not in space. But space and time appear in it as mind.
I is also the mind's imagination.
No.
No, I has defined.
My mind has defined I. The mind has defined I is not I. You'll find out that I have the I have a pointer for that. Your question has the answer already. Because I know all your questions before you ask.
When you said it's nowhere, it's only beyond time and space.
Yes.
It's not that it's not there. It's only beyond that, so we can't define I in terms of a space or something. It's beyond definition.
You're right.
It's all time,
space
all
and time
related
related by one, no?
So that's why then when you say now and here, it is referred to I am.
Mm.
The presence.
Mm.
Okay? The I is absolute. Is not available for you to define in terms of
Nirguna.
Parabrahma.
Parabrahma
Nirguna.
I am becomes Saguna.
There you can say now and here.
Mm-hmm.
And everywhere also.
Mm-hmm.
Because I am is there, everywhere you can say.
Mm-hmm.
But you cannot say for I because everywhere concept doesn't apply there.
Mm-hmm.
Beyond
space and time.
By the I am, but the time and space also got created. Or
Yes, together.
It's together.
Can you go further?
When you say I am as a consciousness.
I am is the manifest consciousness.
I am as a manifest consciousness. We don't relate that with the time and object, right?
No. Manifest consciousness is there, then the manifest, everything in the manifestation appears in that.
Yeah, everything appears in that, but that is to define what we are saying and what we are experiencing. We say there is a manifested consciousness and it experiences everything that's happening. But when we, if we get into, when we do meditation and when we feel that there is only I am, there is only, when you get into that blissful state, there is no time and space.
Correct. When you are in pure I, there's no manifestation.
Yes.
But because of the I am, the manifestation happens.
With respect to the experience, the manifestation happens and then you start relating with objects or time.
So this I am is the witness.
No, no. I is a witness. I am is also a witness, a reflection of I, but it forgets itself and becomes everything.
Reflected witness.
Reflected witness is the same as original witness, but it starts associating the everything else.
So Sahaja Samadhi is not I am zone, it's the I zone.
You cannot separate out I and I am. The moment you go to I, there's no
I am
also. It's just, you can say at the closest, it is a deep sleep like state. Okay? So now, have you understood this much? Brahma Satya, Jagan Mithya. Okay? Why it's Mithya is everything through five sense organs is perception. And every sense organ is limited. With the limited, how can you find out what is there? Okay? So it's a Mithya. And sense organs themselves cannot agree. And mind interprets whatever this not agreed, it mind interprets something. Okay? Brahma Satya Jagamitya, consciousness is real, the world is unreal. Means it's a perception. Okay? So perception is to happen, there should be something which is on which perception is happening. What is that something? Is the consciousness. Consciousness is a subject, it's not an object. It's like a screen. On the screen, the objects appear. Objects are not real. But the screen is real. Jivo Brahmaiva Naparaha. I am Brahman. When I say I am Brahman, what exactly it means? The body, mind and intellect is a perception. The body is perception, the mind is a perception, intellect. Perception is available to experience. But I, the consciousness, is not available to experience, but it is the witness of what's happening. Right? It's the witness of the perception. So I is the knowing principle, we can say. And the perception is known. I is the knowing principle, perception is the known. Okay? Knowing and known. Always we have started looking at a knowing principle. Known is always a perception, a maya. Now we will come to third step. Jagat is Brahman only. The world is Brahman only. What do you mean by that? First he said world is unreal, Jagat is Mithya, now we will come to say Jagat is also Satya. Why? When I see something, see the world, it's a perception. Okay? Perception is unreal, but there's something real behind that. What is that real behind? I. That alone is real. So then when I say the world is perceived, the snake is seen, the snake is unreal, snake is a perception, but rope is real. So in the behind the perceived world, that's real called I, which I alone is reality. Now can I, this is there I there? There's no I there. I is not available there. But on I this world is appearing as a projection. Am I making clear or is there a confusion?
So Shankaracharya says, Niradhara Swarupoham Sarvadharoham
Evachi. I am Adhara for everything.
Yes.
Niradhara Swarupoham. I is, there is no Adhara for that. But everything, the entire world is appearing on I. And where is that I?
Nowhere.
No, I am. I. Guruji. So the world is appearing superimposed on I. The body is superimposed on I. Okay? But I is not there in any of them. Everything is there in this I. You have to understand the difference, okay? the fan, I am not in the fan. I am not in the fan. But fan is in I am. Yeah, when you see perceive the fan, the fan appears to be there.
I is there, I am is there, so fan is there.
Fan is there, but fan is not seen there. Fan is seen in I.
Yes. Because when I sleep, I don't see the fan.
No, that's, you are referring to I am. Okay. What I am saying is, the fan is not in time and space, but fan is in consciousness. It's appearing in consciousness. Okay, let me ask the question the other way. So you are seeing this fan and this room. Where is this fan and the room? The fan and room is in my eyes as the image. Okay. So the entire room is as image in my eyes. So is there an image in the eyes? No, the image is in my brain. So is the image in the brain? No, it's in my consciousness. So entire thing is appearing in my consciousness.
Yes, I may see it in dream also because of that.
Yes. Okay. The entire appearance is consciousness. So everything is in consciousness. So like that you can say, the wave is water. The big wave is water, the small wave is water, but water is not any wave. The fan is consciousness, but consciousness is not fan.
Fan appears in consciousness.
What appears in consciousness also is consciousness. Appearance is not real, consciousness is real. It's confusing everybody. The time and space are also consciousness. Okay? They are appearing in consciousness, but consciousness is not any of them.
So everywhere, nowhere, all this is appearing in consciousness.
Ah, exactly. Yeah. From that perspective, you can say it's a consciousness all pervading. Because there's no concept of pervasion itself. Everything is appearing there only.
This fire, mountain, river, all
is
their existence, no?
That's what I say. They have existence. That existence is appearing in my consciousness. If there is without my consciousness, there's no existence. So the entire appearance is in my consciousness, which is also existence. The consciousness is existence. That's why the mountain appears there. The mountain is not real, existence is real. Let me ask the question like this. This chair exists, right? Does it exist?
It exists even if I am asleep for somebody else, it exists, no?
The somebody else also, when you wake up, you will say. Okay, chair exists for you when you perceive it. It doesn't exist for you when you don't perceive it. Somebody else saying that is a second-hand information. Anything exists because I perceive it. And where is the perception taking place? It's taking place in consciousness. And it appears to be outside.
And that happens again in sleep, it doesn't happen.
In sleep, there's no perception, no? In sleep, the perception has stopped.
But consciousness is the chair is there. No?
Consciousness, no, chair is there, how can you say that? Chair is there, you cannot say. Chair was not there. For example, in your dream, you saw a chair. Does it exist? Okay, but when you go to next again in dream, other people say no, when you went there, the chair is there. So the dream world and dream people and dream chair appear together. What other people say, that other people also came up when you woke up. They are a part of the waking up projection. They came together. They were commented with the chair existed, but they all came together. Chair and the people also came together. Is it clear?
So in sleep, chair is not there.
Sleep chair is not there. Anything exists if they perceive it. And that has no existence. Existence is given by the perceiver, consciousness.
So this is what you are saying when you said there is a forest, a tree fell down and nobody knows about it. So did the tree fall or not?
Tree didn't fall. So Jagat, I am Brahman. And the world is also Brahman. Now this you have to understand. First you say that consciousness and objective perception is Mithya, unreal. Consciousness is real. Okay? How the world can be Brahman? A world can be consciousness?
Then this I is Sat, I am is Chit. Is it okay?
I is Chit, am is Sat. Existence is am. I am.
I is
Chit, consciousness.
I is Chit, okay.
Am is existence.
Am is existence.
So have you understood what I said?
Yeah.
Brahma Satya, Jagamithya. I am Brahman when you say the body is perception. Perception is not real. Okay. But perceiver is real. Perception depends on the perceiver. The wave depends on the water. Water is real, wave is appearance. Like that, the world is appearance, consciousness is real. The world is like a wave, consciousness is like a water. Okay. So body is like a wave, consciousness is like a water. So when I say I am Brahman, I am consciousness, you understand? So when I realize what is consciousness, everything what you experience is also consciousness.
Because of the easiness of the other things.
There is one doubt. So that means Sat comes after Chit only.
No. They are together. It's only way. Our words are Sat, Chit, Ananda.
Mm.
The words we are using it right now.
Mm.
Okay?
But you said I is Chit, am is existence.
Sat, I am existence.
So I am.
Yeah.
So
I am conscious and I am conscious, that's why I am, and the consciousness and existence come together.
Mm.
I am expressing it like that. English words are like that.
Mm.
It's not like these are all words are just a way of representing, no?
But in Vedanta always they speak Sat first and then one Chit.
No, the Vedanta says Sat Chit, but English says for Sat Chit I am.
Mm.
When you say I am, then I refers to consciousness, I am refers to existence. It's not that way, the English has translated from Vedanta.
Mm.
English is a way of expression, the way of expression we are mapping to Vedanta.
Guruji, I have one view here. Jiva, Brahma, Eva.
Huh.
Means Jiva and Brahma is one.
Huh.
Na aparaha means, apara means subject to decay, no? It's prakriti.
No.
What is the meaning of na aparaha?
Na aparaha means no other.
No other.
Paraha means bere.
Because
Paramsa.
Somewhere I read a meaning like that.
No.
Na aparaha means.
No. Not body minded. No, that's some Pandita has done a lot of. Na aparaha means other than Brahman. So that is actually aparaha. You can give body minded intellect meaning you can give, but
it's only to clear the doubt that you are not the body minded.
You can say that.
You are Brahman means you are Jiva and Brahman is one and the same.
Jiva and Brahman one
is
same.
Para. And this is na aparaha means?
You can say that. Aparaha means a lower level reality, you can't say.
Yes.
But here the na aparaha means no other than Brahman. There's no duality. Is it too heavy or? Okay. Is it clear?
Guruji, if we go back and think, is it I am is Shiva and Jagat is Brahman is Shakti?
Shakti.
You said that the chair is there when I am awake and when I sleep the chair is not there. What does that mean?
Chair is not there, the school is not there, nothing is there.
It's
there?
No, not that. When I go to sleep, the chair is not there.
Is it there?
But even when I'm awake also, the chair is not something, some different entity, it's consciousness.
Chair is appearing in consciousness, right? Appearance is not real. When I say chair is an appearance in consciousness, okay, what is real is consciousness. Okay, when I say mirage, water is seen in the mirage, okay, water is not real, sand is real. consciousness real, the appearance appears to be experiential real, but appearance is not real. Okay? But then, what is real is consciousness. So when I say Jagat is Brahman, I say Jagat is consciousness. Appearance is not real. We should separate out appearance from the reality.
So when you say that chair is there when I am awake, you are saying the appearance of...
Appearance of chair is there. Right? You digested chair in the deep sleep. Chair disappeared into your consciousness. And it appeared in the morning. And she says, no, chair was there, somebody else also saw it in the morning. I'll say that somebody else also appeared from consciousness and he woke up in the morning.
And you see, the appearance of a chair is real.
Appearance of chair is not real. It's experiential real.
Experiential.
Experiential reality is not real.
Right.
Right? So all experiences are perceptions and perceptions are not real. What is real is consciousness. Is this much clear?
Yeah.
So when I speak of Advaita, what we are trying to say, okay, what we are trying to say is, convert body, mind, intellect and world into I. Don't suppress the thoughts, but rather find out everything is I. The world is I, but I is not world.